Dr. Sharma. His book is Barack Obama, His Life in Hawaii and Indonesia, the first multicultural president. What do you want to discuss first? European tour?
Whatever, yes, we can talk about that.
Yeah. The election's coming up too?
The election as well, yes.
And your knowledge of the Obama family?
Anything you want to talk about.
Well, first, I think it's important is this. You make a very good point. This is like another, my famous word, paradigm shift. We have a president today who's not the old, I guess you could say, white Anglo-Saxon Protestant president. Not really in the Midwest, not, well, California. Reagan was from Illinois. Black father from Africa, itinerant mother who traveled all over the place. Hawaii was his more stopping, in Indonesia. So how is this, what's the main thrust of your book, how this is so?
Yeah, so that's really the talking point. He's the first president, like Jerry Burris said, the senior political editor for Honolulu Star Advertiser, when I presented this in Hawaii for the book launch. He said, so Dinesh, you mean to say, is this the first guy we've elected who's not from Ohio? Which is, in essence, the case, right? This is the first guy we've elected who's not from the mainland of the country. He's right. From Hawaii, the last state to join the union, the most diverse state in the union. And in many ways, I argue in the book, it's really the state that's pointing to the future of the United States demographically on the mainland, on the continental United States.
How is it about weather, though?
Well, it was the last state to join the union in 1959. There was quite a contentious debate about it. It's a bellwether in the sense that the U.S. Census by 2040 suggests that America will be a 50-50 nation, in the sense that it will be 50% Caucasian and 50% non-white, Hispanic, etc., and various blended ethnicities that are part of the cosmopolitan United States.
In part, you're suggesting that, you know, we might get deceived by, okay, he's our first black president, But we forget that he grew up in a place which is very different from the way an average person would grow up in the middle of America.
Right.
So is that, you know, clearly the headline is true that he's the first African American president in the 232 years history of this country. Yes, no doubt about that. But then when you dig in a little bit deeper, you find that there's other kind of things that are going on, namely the first multicultural head of a Western democracy. Canada, Australia, other parts of Europe have had multiculturalism as a policy, and just recently Merkel, Sarkozy and Cameron even chimed in to say multiculturalism has failed in Europe.
Right.
So how is it that America elected the first multicultural president as we enter the 21st century? It's one of the big questions that has not been debated, has not been asked.
With
really
a name that is not Wilson, Johnson, or Smith.
Exactly. So Barack Hussein Obama.
That when he first came on, that, you know, he had, for American standards, you know, an out there kind of name.
Yeah.
That people had to get real used to.
Well, Hussein's his middle name, too. Right. Well, I thought it was more interesting what you brought up, that people might know he spent some of his time in Indonesia, his stepfather and stuff. I mean, some formative years.
Yeah. So he's the first president who didn't grow up on the mainland, and he's also the first president who was schooled overseas in Southeast Asia and Indonesia in particular, which is the largest Islamic populist democracy in the world. And Hillary Clinton, Paul Wolfowitz, and others have said it is the model that other Islamic countries that are emerging need to follow, because it's a secular populist democracy. They've taken the vote on this many times in Indonesia, and every time they've taken the vote, Indonesians have stood up and said, we're not an Islamic republic, we're a constitutional democracy, unlike Pakistan or other parts
and
of
the
world.
And the jury, they keep separate jury, legislative jury.
Exactly.
And everything.
I mean, it's not
areas of it that aren't there, like Acho.
Exactly.
With the wave very bad.
Exactly.
That's a problem spot.
Yes, it is. So, you know, there are hotbeds in the country that are, because of Wahhabi influence and other influences that are fundamentalists, certainly have become more radical. And then when Obama grew up there in the 70s, late 60s, early 70s, but by far, you know, the more secular model for an Islamic republic to follow. And that's why repeatedly Obama has said this when he was in Indonesia recently and a year ago, that Indonesians should not give in to Al-Qaeda and, you know, terrorist forces and radical forces. It is really the way to go forward for Islamic democracies, right? So that's another big first that Obama has. And then, of course, furthermore, he's really the first president, like you said, who's biracial in a unique kind of way. His father was from Africa, who went back, didn't come back except for 1 month to visit him in the Christmas of 1971. His mother was from Kansas, although a world traveler, the first anthropologist mother with a PhD in cultural anthropology.
Yeah, when I read this book, this woman has some depth to her. I thought she was this kind of loose cannon itinerant who kind of rebelled, you know, leaving Kansas, marrying a black man, especially in the 60s. Yeah. But she did a lot on her own. Maybe it was with Mother of the Year, though. In Indonesia, what was she doing? The anthropology?
She was doing micro-lending, micro-credit.
Part of her time.
Development work. Yeah, that's definitely one perspective, you know, that I take on her in the book, which is that she's really ahead of her times. You know, she was part of she came after the beatnik generation, but before the hippies. That's when she comes of age. So, you know, she was out there traveling, doing micro-lending development work for the rural poor in Indonesia and other parts of the world. And in many ways, I argue in the book, Obama really inherits her dreams to want to change the world, partly. He gets it from her.
What are your thoughts on where the country is going to be in 50 years with multiculturalism?
Well, yes. Oh my God! And in the book, you touch on the book. Obama has entered a very, in the world's changing right now.
Obama is the first instance where we have this change going on. But yeah, these trends will become greater.
Well, you discuss in the book.
Yeah. I have no idea what it'll look like in 50 years, but certainly by 2040, the estimates are based on census that will be a much more blended country, much more blended nation.
Yeah, more colored, definitely more. Yeah. And also the second, third generation. Yeah. Well, my personal feeling, we even see some of a white backlash in some of the, in quotes, red states, Oklahoma and places like that. I think some white